David Hall here with Fred Mitchell. Minutes after the Bears 24-20 loss to the Eagles, tough one for the Bears. You know, to me, it really came down to Olin Kruse said a couple days ago, you need your stars to play like stars in a game like this. The Bears have the ball, minute 50 to go. Jay Cutler's got the opportunity to redeem himself, move the ball downfield, lead the Bears to this game-winning drive, and he throws his 18th interception of the season on the sixth play of the drive. You know, you can't put this all on Cutler, but certainly, not only in that drive, but the rest of the night, he did not play like you need your star to play in a game this big.
And that all came into play in my prediction that the Eagles would win somehow because of their playmakers that they have. And Donovan McNabb is certainly a proven guy there, and they've got some other guys. Deshaun Jackson came up big. Even without Westbrook, the Eagles just somehow, I have a fear they'd prevail.
They did. I mean, you know, Deshaun Jackson makes a big 48-yard touchdown pass over Al Afalava. Did not play the ball very well. The Bears still have a fourth-quarter lead. But they don't stay in their gaps. LeSean McCoy, the rookie, goes off left tackle, and, you know, 10-yard touchdown run. That's the difference in this Bears defense. Played okay, but they needed some more opportunities. They needed to, you know, they had three turnovers, so you can't pin this on the defense. The offense just didn't really execute. And yes, Cutler, after the game, what was the problem? He says, you really don't have any explanation. And that's the frustrating thing for Bears fans, and that's the frustrating thing for a team that's now 4-6, talking playoffs but not realistic.
And you know, David, people are going to pretty much write this season off in terms of the postseason for the Bears. But I think the grander, bigger picture is going to be how to get Jay Cutler to exploit his talent, his abilities, the best in this Bears organization. There's a long-term commitment for Jay Cutler and the Bears, and they've got to make it work somehow.
And, you know, Donovan McNabb on the other side of the ledger, he did play like a star tonight. Nice moment at the end of the game, though, at midfield, the embrace for about 15 seconds at least. And you talked to McNabb about what he had to say for Cutler. Cutler just said he's a first-class dude, but you knew a little bit more of what was said.
Right. You know, Donovan McNabb didn't want to get into the specifics of what was said, but essentially said that he was trying to give a little confidence and show that he empathized with what Jay is going through. Certainly, Donovan McNabb, a future Hall of Famer, went through some tough times early in his career in Philadelphia. So just that fraternity of quarterbacks, he wanted to show that they're sticking with each other.
McNabb knows Chicago. Yep. He knows adversity. Yep. And let's hope that Jay Cutler's hearing was better than his accuracy tonight. From Soldier Field, David Hogg, Fred Mitchell, after the Bears 24-20 loss to the Eagles.